Let's talk about the 1983 World Cup. We can keep talking about Kapil's statistics and performance as a genuine all-rounder. However, if there was any example of one person's faith moving an entire mountain, here it was Kapil's faith in India winning the 1983 World Cup. He inspired, he provided the fighting spirit, killer instincts and brought out the best from everyone. The team was extremely talented, agreed, but he provided the vital ingredient necessary for its victory, that was the self-belief. Because of him, people started believing that India can not just win one match or two matches, but the entire World Cup. Welcome back, guys. Today, India can boast of the best fast bowling attack in the world. The likes of Bhuvaneshwar Kumar, Mohammad Shami, Ishan Sharma, Umesh Yadav and Jasprit Bumrah dominate the cricketing world with their pace, precision and variety. However, times were not the same for India not so long ago. Let us go back in time and check it out for ourselves. Let's go back to a time prior to 1978. Because 1978 was a game-changer year for India. It was the starting point of an international career for the legend Kapil Dev. Before Kapil Dev, the Indian bowling attack constituted Irrappalli Prasanna, Bishan Singh Bedi, Chandrasekhar, Karsan Gowri, Madan Lal and Mohindra Amarnath. Overall, India lacked a genuine pace bowler who could pose a serious threat to the opposition. Meanwhile, the bowler had already taken birth on 6th of January 1959 in Chandigarh, Punjab, Kapil Dev Nikhanj. Not just a fast bowler of international repute, but an international all-rounder from India in his true sense. Did you know that Kapil Dev has got four sisters and two brothers, all of them elder to him? These four sisters were born in Pak Patan in Pakistan, that is before partition. And his family moved after partition to Fazilka in India. So there his two brothers were born, all of them elder to Kapil Dev. Kapil not only broke the stereotype that India does not produce any fast bowlers, but also went on to prove that he is a genuine attacking all-rounder, the best in class. We'll be soon seeing some beautiful deliveries from Kapil Dev, but before that, some interesting trivia. It would be interesting for you to note that he was never run out in his 184 test innings long career. Kapil was the youngest test player to achieve the all-round double of 100 wickets and 1,000 runs. Kapil never missed a test because of injury or fitness reasons in a career that spanned 131 tests spread over 16 years. He was voted as India's Cricketer of the Century during 2002 ahead of Sunil Gavaskar and Sachin Tendulkar. Let's talk about the 1983 World Cup. We can keep talking about Kapil's statistics and performance as a genuine all-rounder. However, if there was any example of one person's faith moving an entire mountain, here it was Kapil's faith in India winning the 1983 World Cup. He inspired, he provided the fighting spirit, killer instincts and brought out the best from everyone. The team was extremely talented, agreed. But he provided the vital ingredient necessary for its victory, that was the self-belief. Because of him, people started believing that India can not just win one match or two matches, but the entire World Cup.
He was charging through, calling Desmond Haynes for two, but didn't quite get it. It would have landed 10 to 15 yards inside the belt. He's gone! Kapil Dev, the skipper, extra cover, Lloyd is caught. gets out. Yes. Cuthelder finally gets his just desserts. Andy Roberts falls, LBW.
Winning the 1983 World Cup was one of the biggest moments of glory in Indian cricket and brought a major turnaround for the sport in the country. And if we can zero down the inspiration to one person, it was Kapil Dev Nikhanj.